Dark Souls. What can be said about Dark Souls? Well, it is a game with beautiful environment design, amazing bosses, precise combat, and it is a game that I very much hate. But this isn't about me, this is about my friend, who has a birthday soon, and he is apparently a masochist, so I asked him what was his favorite game, and he said Dark Souls, so we're making a Dark Souls diorama for his birthday. Yay! So my character of choice for this specific diorama was good old Sir Ornstein the Dragonslayer. Why? Because I think he's cool, and I don't know, he feels like a pretty iconic character from the first game. So for the first step, I scoured the internet and found a STL file for me to print of Sir Ornstein. So I got the model, prepared it by placing some supports and sliced it in the slicer, had some print failures and some technical difficulties with my printer, and then when the model was ready, I began with the cleanup process. Now, the original STL came with a base for good old Sir Ornstein, but I wanted to make my own, so I had to remove it. There was some finagling to do, but I managed to cut it off using the Dremel. Alright, this is it for Voice Over Me. I will pass you down to Past Me so you can experience the trials and tribulations and the overall roller coaster of this project. Take it away, Past Me! Alright, well, that was an ordeal and a half, but it's done and his feet are looking okay-ish. I think it's gonna be hard to tell until I paint it, but I'm fine with it. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this piece of paper and place their lovely Dragonslayer Ornstein above it. I want to plan out the size of the diorama. I looked at the video and I think I'm going to try and draw around it and see how that will work out. Kind of get a feeling of the sizes and dimension before I actually build something. Okay, now that I've finished the base structure, basically by layering a bunch of foam boards together, I'm going to cover it with this Super Sculpey. I'm going to try to create a very thin sheet of this and then basically cover this, laying the brickwork, some details. I also created some etching into green stuff so I can basically press it into the Super Sculpey, instead of needing to carve all the details every time that there is there, because I know there's a lot of ornate details next to the pillars and I don't have all day. So hopefully that will save some time, I don't know, we'll see. Thank you.
So, I f***ed up. man, okay, let's deal with this mess. As you can see, foam core wasn't exactly the best choice as a core for the sculpt. I thought maybe the temperature from the oven might be not too harsh on it. I don't know. I guess I didn't really think it through, but yeah, it completely deformed, and because of the layer of the clay was so thin, it kind of broke it apart. I actually had to take a step back as soon as I saw this. I took a day off after this because I just could not handle it. I was crushed. I was just... I wanted to cry. But we're not stopping here. I need to make the gift for my friend. I'm not giving up now, so I'm just going to have to start all over. All that 3 days work of sculpting this details, it's fine. I'm gonna make a new one. It's gonna be better. But yeah, okay, so let's get on to the new one. And we're back. Let's pretend it didn't take any time at all. Okay, the wood worked perfectly. No cracking, no bloating, no nothing. And it is done, it's baked, we can move on. What I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna take a file, maybe a knife as well. Just go over the grooves a bit, make them a bit more pronounced here. And probably sand off the edges, make them nice and clean. And I also made the floor while I was at it, so I'm going to add the floor details. I felt like it would be easier to add them after the bake, so I'm going to add them with the file as well. Yeah, let's do it! Alright, so I don't exactly remember where we left off, but everything baked out okay, and we cleaned off the edges with some plaster. It didn't come out as clean as I would have liked in the back, but you know, beggars can't be choosers, and I'm fine with it. It's fine, it's just the back. For the bottom, I glued the clay into a thick piece of foam just to elevate it a bit, give it some nicer height. And covered the sides with plaster and sanded them. Now what we're going to do is the most threatening part, I would say, and it is the window parts. All right, let's see how it goes. right, we're done with the building portion of the build. It is done, it is glued up together. All that's left is now to prime and paint it, and then we'll add out the windows effect. Yeah, let's get to it. So we're getting pretty close to the end here, but as I was painting beautiful Sir Ornstein here, I noticed that some of the details of the models aren't really that great or refined, and I want him to be happy with this gift, and I want myself being happy giving it to him. So what I think I'm gonna do is I need to sculpt up the little torn up skirt thing that he has on the sides here, and maybe add some chainmail. I've seen some concept art with that, and I think that would be cool. I'm not actually sure if that's how he is in the game, but more details, less gold, always good. And all of this means that I will need to be sculpting fabric and little details, and you know what that means, kids. More green stuff! Yay! Kill me.
Thank you.
Alright, well, Ornstein is pretty much done. I like the way it turned out. I think the cloth being ripped off is a much better look than how it looked before. Now, before I add the window, I think what I want to do is spray a bit of gold, like very subtly, on the edges of the window still. I hope it will work. What I'm trying to achieve is basically when you fight him in that area, there's just a lot of light coming through the window. So I'm trying to mimic that kind of effect. It kind of looked cool when I just sprayed it gold in the first time, so I'm hoping maybe it'll have a nice effect. I'll try to be very subtle with this in case it doesn't work. Yeah, wish me luck. Alright, one airbrushing session later, and I think that we're overall done. Yeah, I don't know, I kind of like it and I kind of don't like it at the same time. I think it looks really good on the floor. I don't know if you can see it on the camera very well, but I did on overall like a very light coat of gold over the floor, and it has like a nice sheen to it with brighter intensity next to the window. It's all right, I think. It's fine. Okay, for the last touch, we're going to add the window, and I'm going to use UV resin for this, and I'm going to mix it with some yellow ink. I've tried it before and it seemed to work fine. The resin cures and hardens pretty easily. I am worried that because it's such a big amount, it might heat up very intensely and kind of warp, so I'm going to try to cure it slowly, but that's a worry for later. And yeah, let's mix up some resin. Alright, well, before I show you the final shots, I just want to say for the record that I find it absolutely poetic that the project that gave me so much trouble and heartache, and it was an absolute roller coaster, is about Dark Souls. But yeah, as much as Dark Souls is a pain in my booty, I absolutely love the result. And I'm really proud of the video as well, so I hope you enjoyed it. And yeah, no more delaying. Let's roll the final shots!